Okay, this is Daniel. I was posed a question about the difference between using a heat gun that's shown on YouTube as opposed to using a BGA welder like the one I use. Okay, the difference is IR allows me to get a very deep heat into the chip in order to reflow the solder balls beneath the chips without them liquefying and making mush underneath it, okay? I'm able to get a precise heat for a precise length of time using a heat gun that is designed primarily for removing paint from furniture. Just don't do it. The temperatures can range, have a fluctuation range between 200 and 300 degrees from one outlet in the house to another. Now the guy showing you count to 20, the power output in his house, it can be higher or lower than the power output in your house. You may count to 20 on yours and make total mush out of it, or for that matter, catch the board on fire. Okay, or it could just be too cold to allow it to reflow. I don't know about you, but I wouldn't want to take that chance because it becomes less than 50% using a heat gun. All right. Now, it's live and learn. If you try it, then you know that's the risk you plan on taking. So hopefully this clears up a little bit as far as the difference between a heat gun and professional equipment like what I use. All right. Thank you.